afford to wait for Arendelle. Not in his condition. The Deadwalkers will be scouring the city to find out who killed their lich. We gotta get back to the camp, fast.
We waste our time here. The fate of these people is sealed. The sole act that can defeat the Necromancers is to take back the stolen energy of the World Heart.
I decide what has to be done, with or without your agreement.
Mercenary, the Sentinels and the other group were killed by Deadwalkers, and there's a group of undead on the road, stopping anyone from getting through.
I'll see what I can do.
Mercenary, it is well that you are returned. A creature that seemed like a dead thing came. It claimed you had sent it.
Yeah. He's a potential ally, don't worry about it.
I fear I attacked it. Him. And arrested him. He tried to talk to me, but I felt safer with it under guard. Considering its... I mean, his... face.
Where is he now?
He is with the Red Scribes.
Perfect. Mathras, got a moment?
My dear, I have all of eternity.
Talk to you later. What can you tell me about Mathras?
He is a most unusual being. Do you realize he has been alive for over 6,000 years?
Do you ever get the feeling that he's just talking bullshit?
Even though at first sight, such a long existence sounds impossible, he has knowledge of history that makes it very difficult for us to doubt his word. And his appearance speaks for itself, if I may be so bold.
It's true that he does look a bit... ripe.
As far as I understand it, he regularly changes his bodies. As soon as the one he's taken starts wearing out, he procures a new... frame? What is really fascinating is that he is the kind of undead that was previously unheard of. We had no idea there was a being able to transfer their soul from one body to another in order to keep living. Remember that his knowledge could very well turn our vision of mortality upside down. And of course he might provide unhoped-for help against the Lords of the Frozen Shadows.
What did I tell you? Once they've recovered from the shock of my somewhat shriveled appearance, everybody thinks I'm highly useful.
He could really help us out. If only we could be sure he wasn't working for the enemy.
You insult me yet again. Joining forces with a band of apprentice sorcerers with a thirst for power would be unworthy of my condition. And didn't I already tell you how to enter the city?
Some basic information that got you into our camp. Seems pretty clever to me.
Really? What would be in it for me? Not that the company of these scribes is unpleasant, but I doubt that our simple little discussions will affect the course of the war.
I can confirm that he hasn't ever been alone. But you look a bit preoccupied with something. Am I right?
The commander says there's a traitor in the camp, and our new friend is obviously a prime suspect. What if he can read minds?
Well, I think that the commander is wrong. We've spoken for a long time with Mathras, and I don't believe for a second that he's got anything to do with your problem. It's obviously very difficult to detect telepathic communication, but as far as I can see, there's nothing to indicate he's capable of it.
Very well. I'll just have to trust you. I'll be going now.
They attacked the wrong person. How dare they condemn our king to such a macabre fate? It's time for us to repay the Deadwalkers in kind. I want to see them destroyed, so not a single one of those dead ever dare set foot in our streets again. We're going to launch a massive assault to take back our city. It is time to turn the tide of this war. Vulcan, we will need you and your extraordinary abilities. We have to send a small group to open the city gates. I'm counting on you. I know that you can be stealthy and incredibly effective. A few soldiers will be going with you. This is our best chance. Blackfrost doesn't seem to be here anymore, and most of his forces went with him. But before we launch the assault, we need to strengthen our army. I've been told there are prisoners in the city. If we free those soldiers, we can add them to our ranks. We're also going to need to get our equipment in as good shape as possible. We're fortunate that our smith has survived. Let us hope he'll be able to provide us with everything we need, but it's better to make sure.
Thou doth make a great error. The only thing that counts is reaching the World Heart, and the Necromancer, or rather his palace, is the key. We should go there now.
Vulcan, I need your help.
What? Sorting books? Observing swamp critters? You don't think I have better things to do right now?
That's not fair. I'm not stupid. I understand that what is most important now is the fight, and our soldiers...
The Freeborn Blades will do just fine. Don't you worry about that.
Not them, the other human soldiers.
What's the problem?
I'm not sure we can count on them. They've already lost the war. They're only staying here because the elves are protecting them. But they've got no fight left in them. They have to believe they can win. They have to fight alongside the elves and the Freeborn Blades. I've tried talking with them, but they treat me like a child. Maybe they would listen if you would talk to them.
Me? Most regular army guys don't have any time for mercenaries.
They just need to get their spirit back, boost their morale. I'm sure you could find some words to help them.
Vulcan, come here. I need to talk to you about something. While you were in the city, the Deadwalkers apparently began stirring. Several scouts have disappeared without a trace. They can't just have been ambushed by chance. Someone must have given their roots to our enemies. I'm afraid we have a traitor among us. Though if that's the case, I don't understand why we haven't been attacked by the Deadwalkers yet. What's really troubling is that these disappearances pretty much correspond to your arrival here, which means that your living dead friend is the prime suspect. Even if it's just as possible that it's one of the Red Scribes, or even one of your people.
And why can't it be one of your people?
Why would he do that? And above all, why would he wait until now to betray us?
With your army decimated, and hearing that the king's dead, a soldier might really decide that the war's lost. There's no more hope. Day after day, hoping for a miracle. That gives way to the darkest of miseries. And in the end, he's had it, and wants it over and done with.
Maybe. Regardless, we have to find the spy and silence him. You have demonstrated your effectiveness and discretion. Can you take care of this?
Of course. I'll look into it.
Vulcan, I have to talk to you about Edwin. I saw you getting friendly with her. You should be more careful. She is not what she pretends to be.
I know she's not playing straight with us. She's got her little secrets, just like everyone else.
You don't understand. It's a lot more serious than little secrets. I found some very worrying information in one of the last books I read. 200 or 300 years ago, there were other groups of sages and magicians, like the Red Scribes. One of these orders was called the White Lords.
Hmm. So you think that they were the ancestors of the Ice Lords or something? What does that have to do with Edwin?
I'm getting to that. The White Lords lived in the north of Vertil, out in the ice. We know little about them. For a long time, it was believed they had disappeared. But in reality, they somehow transformed themselves. And in one of the books that I consulted, I found an engraving of a woman. one of their leaders. It was the portrait of that witch.
It is suspicious. We'll have to check it out.
Since you seem so close to her, try to find out more about her past. How old is she? Where was she born? I don't know. Just something, anything that might give her away.
I'll have to be careful so she doesn't get wise to me.
Keep me informed, but believe me, I'm almost sure it is her.
See you later. Make it quick. We're going to storm the city. With you, we have a chance.
Knock it off, okay? Chance or not, I got no reason to risk my hide or my men's for that bunch of lazy bastards who, until now, have let us die without lifting a finger. Show us you're worth more than they are, and we'll see. Maybe.
What better way to prove my worth than a duel? That's how we settle differences of opinion in my company a lot of the time. All right?
I got a guy who should make you happy. If you beat him, I might change my mind. With what you got under your belt, who knows? Well, you can really back up your words, mercenary. Who knows? Maybe with guys like you, we can actually win. We're with you, Vulcan. You can count on us for the assault.
An undead? In our camp? Aren't you afraid it'll communicate with its masters?
It's a calculated risk. Your friend Edwin told me that she can interrogate those creatures, so we captured one.
You really can do some pretty weird things.
Listen, Vulcan. We're not going to turn down any information. If we can find out how to haul our asses out of the fire, I don't see how it can hurt. Ready to make it talk?
If a fire breather doesn't need me right away, I can start getting ready.
Excellent. Let's start the interrogation.
Listen, maggot head. You're going to tell us everything you know.
That's not quite how it works, Captain. It can't just answer questions like that. Tell me what you want to know, and I'll dig around in its memory to find the answers.
In that case, why not dig everything out, so we don't miss anything?
Even for someone as skilled as me, that could take weeks. Its brain, however limited, is like an immense archive that contains both recent memories and memories of its past life.
All right. I want to know if that bastard Black Frost really has left the area.
Let me concentrate. Yes. I see him raising the wave and turning the whole city into ice. This soldier must have been at his feet. Then he gave the order to attack, and gave orders to several powerful undead. Apparently he left right after. He appears nowhere else in its memory.
What were Black Frost's orders?
You have to understand that this creature's ability to comprehend is limited. From what I can see, it was told to keep watch over the city. He asked to be sent living people. Prisoners. The other living people must still be alive and under guard. Other prisoners. And of course, that he be informed in the event of trouble.
Does he know we entered the city?
This dead thing doesn't, anyway. But that doesn't mean a thing, unfortunately.
What are those powerful dead you were talking about?
I see a flying creature, like the one in the swamp, and others. But the image is blurred.
So is the army being commanded by a Tormentor now?
No, I don't think so. They make good spies, but poor leaders. That said, I don't see any real generals.
Nothing that looks like that one that attacked the village.
No, but Black Frost will definitely have left someone in charge. Someone he trusts. This soldier just didn't see who. I think that he... Oh no! He saw me!
Huh? Who are you talking about?
Well, well. Probing the spirits of the dead. You can well imagine that this sort of communication goes both ways. So, that's where my dear rebels are hiding, isn't it?
I must break the link! Right now!
Edwin, I need to speak to you.
What can I do for you?
Hey, thanks for your help. Without you, we would have never gotten anything out of that dead stiff.
You know me, I just love to be helpful.
I would like to ask you a few questions. What's the story with this Mathras guy? Who is he?
It's hard to say. He's one of the living dead. Of that I'm completely certain. But he is able to do things no other species of revenant has ever done before. You must understand that necromancy, the magic that allows the dead to be reanimated, is based upon one principle: giving energy to lifeless bodies. Mathras functions differently somehow. It is not his body that has been brought back to life, but rather his mind, which has survived his body.
He says he's 6,000 years old. You believe that?
It is entirely possible. His spirit is in theory immortal. This magic is far different from that which is practiced in Vertiol. Instead of drawing energy from the world heart, he draws energy directly from the body he is possessing.
Could that have anything to do with the Ice Lords? Or my demon?
Absolutely not.
Aren't you cold like that?
Are you afraid you're no longer the master of the situation? Because I'm showing a little too much skin?
I was simply concerned about your health.
Oh, how touching. But after having spent nights on end, trapped in a cage in the middle of the swamps, I can assure you that catching a cold is not highest on the list of things I worry about.
Thanks. The mercenary salutes you, knight. I'll leave you. Sybil, can I talk to you?
Yes.
I need your help.
If you want.
Have you heard about all this spy business?
Yeah, the elf commander told me. They suspect us. Us and the Red Scribes.
Now that would be priceless. If that long-faced twat accuses us of being traitors.
Who do you think it could be?
I confess that at first I thought it was your pal who looks like you just dug him up.
Mathras? Honestly, I don't think so.
I agree. I realized that since he's permanently surrounded by the Scribes, he'd have a hard job finding the time to betray us.
Do you think it's one of the Scribes?
It's possible. After all, it wouldn't be the first time they've shagged us while we had our backs turned. But whoever the mole is has to know their way around and not be scared to go outside on their own. Can you see any of those snot-nosed weeds taking that kind of risk? The most likely, whatever Commander Pointy Ears thinks, is that one of his boys is a turncoat. Go and check with Buffalo. I saw him chasing one a while back.
Considering the size of him, I doubt he caught the guy. I'll go ask him. You know, I wanted to ask... I gotta go. Buffalo, I have to talk to you.
What do you want?
You were seen leaving the camp. What were you doing?
What business is that of yours? Are you spying on me?
I'm not accusing you of anything. I'm supposed to be searching for a spy, and I need some clues.
I was just out on a little recon. I don't see how that can help you.
They told me that you were looking for someone.
Yes. The soldier who was on watch just over there. He left his post, was trying to follow him, but he lost me. He knows the terrain better than I do. I followed his tracks for a while, but considering the number of deadwalkers in the area, I decided to come back. I didn't want to give away our position.
Where did the tracks lead to?
Over toward the river, but don't bother. The guard already came back. He's just over there. You could go and ask him yourself.
I guess that's what I'll do. Thanks for the tip.
Can I help you with something, mercenary?
I was told you left your post.
That's... no, never. Who told you such a thing?
You think I'd tell you? Come on. Tell me everything, or you'll really be in the shit.
All right. I left, but only once. I was following your comrade, Buffalo. He went to the main gates of the city. I figured that was pretty suspicious. But I didn't dare go very far. I couldn't leave my post unguarded, you understand? And then the Deadwalkers didn't seem about to attack him. In the end, he went back without a scratch and without saying a thing.
Your stories are starting to piss me off. Time to die, traitor.
Anyway, we're all going to die, today or tomorrow. What difference does it make? But I'm going to come back to life. My master promised me.
Yeah, and you'll be one more dead grunt in his mob, stupid idiot.
I heard you caught the mole. I hope you don't think it's me anymore.
We can't take all of them. Let's concentrate on anything to do with necromancy, healing, and of course anything about the World Heart.
Pass me the books you have. I can't carry any more. I need to keep my hands free in case we have to fight.